The reason we started that movement is because that policy of stop and frisk has not been doing anything in the community other than making people feel uncomfortable, people being harassed on a daily basis, and also being dehumanized on a daily basis. Also, the youth from the ages of 14 to 24 have been criminalized in such a high extent, right, that now the population, the prison population, has risen to close to 2.5 million people. Right? The majority of them affected is people of color, because those are the ones that's being targeted by this policy, stop, question, and frisk. Now, another thing that we have to understand is, right, that 2011, they stopped 685,724 people. Right? 85% of those people they stopped, right, was people of color. 90% of those people they stopped, we talk about close to 600,000 stops, was people that did not commit a crime, was not given any type of ticket, was not locked up. So we talk about 600,000 people, innocent people, just walking up and down the street, being stopped by police and harassed for no reason at all, just because they felt like they needed to go fishing, because that's what they call it, fishing. They go fishing hoping that they find something in somebody. Right? Now, in 2011, the only thing they recovered was 0.1 of guns. We talking about out of every 2,000 to 3,000 people they stopped, they got one gun. That's not cutting down in crime. And if we look at it, in this year alone, crime has went down. Stop and frisk was pulled back a little bit. It's still happening because the CPU unit, which is the cop patrol unit that I created, and we are in the five boroughs working, right? That cop patrol unit, we have a lot of videos that we document. Police is still harassing people, still stopping people. The only thing they're not doing is filling up that UF-250 form, right? So we have a lot of documentary on that. They're not filling out the UF-250 form, so in reality, it's not being put down into the system as people being stopped. So it has continued, but it's just, you know what I'm saying, it's not documented like it was being documented before. Now, the thing that we have to understand that Quinn, right, she supports stop and frisk. I mean, she was in the hearings of stop and frisk, talking about reforming it. We don't believe you can reform something that just doesn't, you know, that doesn't work in the community, especially of color. If something, I mean, even if you stop 10,000 people and the majority is going to be people of color, it's still the same thing. It's still going to be considered harassment. It's still going to be considered racial profiling, right? And it's not helping out with the crime. So we don't need this policy to continue. Christy Quinn wants to continue this policy, right? She also financially, through the budget, has supported this policy. She just recently put some more money into this policy, right? If she's elected as mayor, she wants to keep Commissioner Raymond Kelly on board, which is something that we don't want, because he has done nothing in the past 4 years but created an uncomfortable situation, unsafe environment for people of all colors and all races. And we do not need somebody like that to continue, right, to run this police force, who has made this police force into some kind of a military army, you're saying, military army base. So we need to find, you know what I'm saying, a way to make sure that she don't get elected. But as you see, there's people of all different races that don't want her, you know what I'm saying, to have that position. So hopefully we'll keep fighting and we keep pushing forward, and we'll have a mayor that will make sense and will be for the people and not just for the, you know what I'm saying, 1% and the politicians, and be a sellout like all these other ones. So, power to